Okay guys, today on Nomadic Delights, I have Ahmed, the founder and CEO of Rocktonica. So now let me tell you a bit of Rocktonica. Rocktonica is a company he founded 5 years ago. It handcrafts and sells high-end luxury jewelry. They've shipped to over 50 countries so far and are loved by their customers due to their rock star customer service and super high quality. All right, full disclosure, Ahmed is an old school friend of mine. So, Ahmed, welcome to the show and thank you for coming on. I've been trying to get you on, so thank you for coming on.
Mohammed, it's a pleasure. Thanks for having me on.
All right. Well, first thing first, as your friend and also as a guy who wants to ask you this question, what led you, Ahmed, my old school friend, to one day wake up and say, I'm going to start a company called Rocktonica? Tell me about that.
So my journey with Rocktonica, I come from a design background. I studied architecture.
Okay.
So that opens so many doors to you, not just in terms of, like designing buildings, but I think that, once you're a designer, you're able to design anything, whether it's a building or, objects or jewelry or clothes or whatever. You call yourself your designer.
True.
Especially nowadays. So I know that I wanted to create something that was design orientated.
Okay.
My passion for design.
Yep.
A way for me to express that. And I also always had a passion for jewelry.
Okay.
From a very young age. And I remember my dad would always travel to all these places and, bring me back a gift or a souvenir. And it would be, in a form of jewelry. And, if we look at that throughout the ages, that jewelry has always been a sign and, a gesture of friendship, of relationships, of pacts. Think of weddings, gifts and so on. It's a way to, it's a keepsake, for you to always remember someone wherever you are, because it's a form of art that you're actually wearing on your body.
Yep. No, no,
and always
so
with you.
True.
So, I would always go and sort of look for a piece of jewelry for myself that I wanted to buy.
Mm.
And not really find something that was, worthy.
Yep.
Or something that I kind of, really liked.
And let me get this, as a young man, or even because usually jewelry is not for men, so is this...
No, this happened later on. This happened sort of, around my, I would say like early 20s.
Okay.
To mid 20s.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, I just wouldn't find someone. I know when you're traveling...
Yeah.
You would go, to these little beachside places and just buy those cheap sort of bracelets that would just like tear off after a few days.
I bought a few of those trinkets in the past, so I know what you mean.
Exactly, those kind of friendship bracelet style, that we all bought, right? Because we wanted something. But it's not something that's designed to last.
Correct.
And I really felt that, I could create something.
Okay.
And bring something new to the market. And I mean, long story short is that, I managed to develop a collection that I brought into market as the first collection, and it just received phenomenal success, really, and feedback from customers way beyond my expectation.
And this is your first collection?
This was my first collection,
Was it also known as Rocktonica back then, or was it?
So actually, to be honest, it's an interesting question, because Rocktonica was Rocktonica before Rocktonica was Rocktonica.
Okay. So break it down for me.
So I always knew that I wanted to create a jewelry brand someday.
Okay.
And I sort of had so many of the design, the ethos, the branding, the message, the style, all set out, I had it all mapped out, but it just sat on a shelf, not executed.
Okay.
But with Rocktonica already being the name.
Right.
So I had this brand that was all set up, and you know, I was working on something else at the time, and the stars were simply weren't aligned. And one day that project came off the shelf and it was time to kind of put into action. So it was always Rocktonica.
Nice. Okay. So then now I understand what led you to create Rocktonica. How you, it wasn't just a case of you woke up, you've actually planned this for quite a while. I can see the whole history, the imprint of your dad giving you jewelry. The question is the name Rocktonica.
Yeah, so I mean, you know, there's lots of rock influence in the brand.
Okay.
So, you know, rock sort of, I think music and fashion are so interlinked.
True.
You know,
true.
Now every fashion designer wants to be a musician, and every musician wants to be a fashion designer. You know, that's kind of how it is. And it's throughout the ages, you know, if you remember, or throughout, you know, especially, you know, as way back as we remember,
yeah,
that a lot of the fashion came from music.
True.
You would watch some music videos and that would be your insight to the latest fashion or the cool or the fashion that was it
at
that moment.
Very true.
So fashion and music really go hand in hand much more than you think.
Yeah.
And for me, it was a rock influence, and how beautifully sort of that sort of marriage worked in my mind.
Right.
You know, so bringing something fresh to the rock style sort of, you know, image, you know. So a rejuvenated rock style, if you will.
Well, I mean, one thing for sure, because I mean, I do know one or two rocks. So it was good to see when I was doing my research on your brand, see all the rock influence. The question I have, and I can give my own personal perspective or my own personal spin to it. A guy like me, I don't normally wear jewelry. So for you, you were blessed growing up, your dad was able to give you some nice jewelry. So when you found this gap in the market, you decided to create Rocktonica. You know, like you said, fashion and you know, something that's, you know, that you actually can identify. Now, what surprised me, even though you are an old school friend, was that I was still inspired by your products. And I felt like it provided me something that, you know, was, you know, how would you say, that I wouldn't normally wear. So when I became a customer to Rocktonica by buying one of these pieces, and I actually said to myself, you know what, you've made me a custom-made piece. And I love the name you gave it to. It was Black Mambasa. You know, it was really cool.
Black Mambasa, yes.
Yeah, so it's like you've really played on the whole kind of roots. And but the question I have is that for me as a man who's never been influenced by jewelry, are most of your, you know, your target, not your target, sorry, are most of your customers people like me who just fell upon your brand, or is it people actually go out looking for this? Who is the biggest kind of how these customers you have?
Yeah, so I mean, it's such a big mix of people.
Okay.
I mean, most of our customers are sort of travelers, people. People.
Sorry to cut you. Are they men or female?
So, I mean, it's a mix of both.
Okay.
Predominantly, it's men at the moment.
Right. I'll be honest. I'm asking these questions because for me, I don't normally buy it, but the fact that there's now this market for it. So go ahead. Sorry to cut you off, Ahmed.
No worries. Yeah. So, it's everyone. Everyone has a different story,
okay.
And you know, I've learned along the way that you cannot really put customers in a box.
Okay.
And say, oh, this is the kind of customers that we have, or
this is
what our customer look like.
Yeah.
You know, there are certain elements.
Yeah.
That I think every business owner should identify.
Okay.
But it's usually not the things that you think they are.
Okay.
If that makes sense. You know,
so
maybe you think of jewelry and you think, oh, you know, it would be some kind of like outlandish, jazzy,
yeah,
snazzy, eccentric kind of person that would wear jewelry.
Yeah.
Whereas you're a perfect example.
I'm none of that. All that stuff you just mentioned.
You know, that, you know, you know, you're not the kind of guy that would wear like ripped jeans, skinny jeans,
correct,
and you know, tight jeans and boots and leather jacket.
I like my comfort, yeah.
So if I, you know, if I had I actually put that box,
yeah,
and put, you know, and try to put my customers in it, I would miss out on lots of people like yourself.
Correct.
So which cool. would want to buy our jewelry, which are interested in jewelry, you know. So it's, you know, the connection is, like I said, it's not what you think it is. It's yeah. more about how jewelry makes you feel.
Yes.
And that's the most important thing, is that how it makes you feel, you know, does it make you feel confident? Does it make you feel, you know, does it make you feel fearless?
Yeah.
Does it make you feel, does it make you stand out? Does it make you get noticed?
Yeah.
Does it make you more attractive to the opposite sex? You know, it's a number of things, and to everyone is different, mm-hmm. but it's all about how it makes you feel, the emotion. When you put something on, you know, if it feels good, you're gonna like it, you're gonna fall in love with it, you're gonna be happy to pay a good price for yeah. it, and you're gonna value it.
Yeah, no,
that's what it comes down to.
Well, no, I you've hit the nail, because for me, and like you said, I don't really fit in those kind of boxes, but I do like how it makes me feel. I do like how it was custom made for me. I do like that, you know, it's like it's a long lasting item. But anyway, my other question, this market jewelry, which I never realized before until I started researching, is very crowded. So how does Rocktonica stand out from its competitors?
I mean, I think that, you know, every business has competitors, mm-hmm. and I think that's just that's healthy.
Yeah.
And anyone who thinks that they don't have competitors, you know, is, you know, it's delusional, really.
Yeah. But how do you stand up? So you've touched upon a few things that how it makes
yeah,
you
so
feel.
I think number one, actually, or I'm not going to put this in any particular order, but yeah. one of the most important things I would say is customer service.
Mm.
So true. And, you know, it's interesting that I say customer service before design,
mm.
Because design just goes simply without saying. It's the core. You know, it's the thing that's going to even get you customers in the first place. But I think right at the very start, we just simply looked at customer service because we kind of felt pretty confidently that we were in tune with our brand and what we wanted to represent in terms of design.
Yeah.
But customer service was something that we had to work on even more.
Okay.
And that's something really, really that if you speak to any of our customers, they would tell you that, you know, the customer service is something that they appreciate.
No.
You know, after that, I would say, you know, definitely design. That's, you know, hugely important, yeah. you know, to be, you know, sort of to be on the ball in terms of trends, in terms of design, in terms of colors, what's happening. And this scene moves so quickly that
yeah.
you really have to sort of keep your, you know, finger on the pulse.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think it just comes down to basics. You know, I think that any business, people try to put so many bells and whistles that I'm going to put all these bells and whistles. And by putting all these bells and whistles, I'm going to start to stand out in the market.
Mm.
But the thing is, you put too many bells and whistles, you just start to look like a clown.
Mm.
You know, like you don't really start to look like a respectable business.
Mm-hmm.
And you get you may get attraction, but maybe for the wrong reason. But if you stick to the principles and actually just double down, triple down even on those businesses, and just go like an inch wide and a mile deep.
Okay.
You know, so instead of trying to go a mile wide yeah. and an inch deep.
Honestly, that's a good saying. I'm going to use that going forward.
So yeah, sure. So, you know, and you know, if you look at them as pillars, you just look at, you know, good design, good customer service, you know, good branding,
yeah.
good marketing. You know, if you get these, you know, if you get these points right,
yeah.
and really drill down and double down and triple down, then I think that you're already like distinguished yourself from lots of the competition that I think tend to miss the basics.
Okay.
So, yeah. If I were to summarize, focus on the basics, and I think for us, that's what distinguishes us.
Okay, no, that's honestly a really good insight to make me understand better why Rocktonica stands out. And like you said, it's the customer service rock star. I love that, you know, little phrase. Okay, quick question. This is for people who are starting out.
Yeah,
in business.
I mean, sorry, but yeah. we call our. Us, what we call our customer service rock star customer service, and that's something we're really proud about.
No, it's I love it because it's like when I was doing my research on the website and I said, yo, you guys really know how to, you know, hit the spot on that. Okay, what for me, I like to know for people who are going to start out in business, what is the fun part, the best part of being a business owner?
So the fun part is definitely seeing an idea through from conception to fruition.
Okay.
You know, just to see that process come to, you know, from an idea in your head to a product that's worn, you know, on a customer's wrist or, you know, a necklace or around the neck or whatever it may be. That's really fun. And then I think getting the feedback from customers.
Yeah.
That's something really, really special. I mean, that's something until today, I think that never goes away.
Yeah.
That never really gets old. Like, there's many times where, you know, I think about the responsibility that we have as business owners, or I have as a business owner, and sort of the seriousness of that. You know, I think about that a lot. So, you know, for someone else, it might be something silly, or it might be something that is not, let's say, not a big deal for them.
Yeah.
You know, but for the customer, it's something very, very important. You know, it just means a lot.
Okay.
Like,
okay.
You know, your bracelet, for example.
Yeah. I was just about to ask you that. So, exactly,
you know,
could you jump in?
I know this bracelet just simply means a lot to you right now.
It's definitely.
And I know that it's something important.
Yeah.
You know, and I know that, you know, if this bracelet, you know, for whatever reason, you know, you need some work done on it, or you need it to be adjusted or resized,
mm-hmm.
you want to make sure that it's done and it's really important for you.
Mm.
So, you know. Or for example, if someone's buying a gift,
yeah.
and this gift is like a wedding anniversary,
yes.
That's really important for that customer.
Yeah.
They want that moment that they're planning to be perfect, and you are part of this moment, so
yeah.
You must deliver, and you must take that seriously.
Okay.
And a lot of people, I think, don't. They say, oh, I'm just making XYZ.
Yeah.
You know, I'm just making, I don't know. You know, I'm just making a product, or just doing this service, or is just this, or is just that. If you start thinking, oh, it's just,
yeah.
You're not taking something so seriously, because, or you kind of get put down by people who are just telling you, oh, is that just what it is?
Okay.
You know, well, yeah, maybe to you, but to a lot of people,
yeah.
And to my customers and the customers that I want. It means so much more than that.
Nice. Now, I can tell you, and again, you know, I can be a bit biased, but really, I felt you actually listened to me when I was trying to convey what I'm trying to get. And the thing that I like is that even from my next order, you've already understood me as a customer. So it's easier to create another customer, because I am going to be a hard ass customer to you, because once we're old school friends, and like, but at the same time, at the same time, you still put up with my BS, and you just made me this bracelet that made me feel special.
Well, I mean, it's not BS.
Yeah.
Because it's just, you know, I mean, it's a request, you know, it's a request made by a customer. So if you are able to fulfill that request,
yeah.
Then that should be taken seriously, as I said before.
Yeah.
If you're not, then you need to be clear to the customer and, you know, communicate that. So yeah, it's you know, it's part of the job.
Okay, so we've covered the fun part, and like you said, the whole like start idea to fruition, that's all good. Now let's flip the script. What's the worst part about being a business owner?
I wouldn't say that there's anything that I would call the worst part.
Okay.
But there are definitely lots of challenges.
Okay.
And if you think that there are worse parts, then I think business is not really for you.
Mm.
And maybe, you know, you should look at other things.
Okay.
But if you are willing to accept challenges,
yeah,
then, and there will be plenty.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. Because
a different story. And I think that the challenges are, you know, like I said, there are plenty. It's about juggling,
yeah,
and wearing different hats at the same time, you know, from designing to marketing to, I always try to sort of summarize this by saying there is no no.
Okay.
There is no does not exist. You know, it's either that you know how to do something,
mm-hmm,
and you need to do it and you will do it,
yeah,
or you don't know how to do something and you're going to learn how to do it and, yes, then you will do it. These are the two only options available,
yeah,
and you need to basically learn how to do things very fast and be confident that you will be doing something even before knowing how to do that thing.
Okay.
You know, so I mean, one of the people that, you know, I think has influenced me like quite a lot since, you know, very young age is Tony Robbins.
Mm.
And, you know, he has a saying that says, you know, get in your head and you're dead. You know, if you start thinking about something too much and think about the mechanics of things, you know, on how are you going to do this, how are you going to do that,
yeah,
then, you know, you're dead. You're never going to take, that idea will never take off. It will never happen.
Okay.
But if you start thinking that, yes, I will do that, and we worry about how later, then that idea is much more likely to happen. So, yeah.
No, but that's honestly a good advice, especially from a legend like Tony Robbins. And I think that's actually a good way of thinking. And I like how what he said, if you think there's going to be the worst part about being business, don't go into business. It's so true. There will be challenges. I really like that mentality.
Because, there are a lot of like entrepreneurs.
Yeah. Okay.
That, you know, they're interested in the idea of being an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
Because it's just so cool, you know. And, but they're not prepared to do the work. You know, so in that case, you know, I think, you know, again, I'll mention a big name, and you know, Gary Vee.
Oh yeah, yeah, another legend.
And you know, he always talks about self-awareness.
Yeah.
And he always talks about self-awareness, but like every time I kind of think about this, I understand more, you know, deeper. It's like being aware of your own limitations.
Yeah.
And what you can do. And what you're really good at,
mm,
you know, and if you really kind of have that self-awareness and you understand yourself really, really well, and you're very honest and open with yourself, that, you know, I think things, you know, you just look at things differently.
Right. No, that's a good one. And okay, let me now move a bit back to Rocktonica and the jewelry. Okay. So my first question is that when I look at all of the products on your website, and of course, you know, I'm going to be biased towards mine. So you're wearing a bracelet right now. What is the name of that one? And is it your favorite piece? Or is the one you made me your favorite one?
I mean, they're all my favorite, right?
Okay.
It's like, you know, I asked a friend of mine, I asked a friend of mine,
yeah,
you know, who's your favorite kid?
That's a bit below the belt.
And you know, he said to me, I'm never gonna say that, you know. And I think, you know, once you release art,
yeah,
or and design, you know, they're all kind of your babies, so you can't really say, so they're all my favorite. But this piece right here,
yeah,
is called White Snake.
So it looks really cool, honestly.
This is a really good example. This is actually the second iteration of this design.
Oh, so you actually make different iteration, but do you keep the original on the website or do
no, you... So the design evolves.
Okay. Yes.
You know, if it needs to be, if it needs to, so we would make a design and sort of wear it for a few weeks and test each design.
Nice.
Just to know how it feels, how the stone feel, how, you know, the energy of the piece. And actually, like, you know, talking about energy, I mean, we actually cleanse every single piece with a special kind of wood that comes from the Amazon called Palo Santo.
Okay.
And we sort of like cleanse the piece with the smoke of the wood.
Nice.
And we believe that every stone,
yeah,
you know, has sort of like traveled and been touched by so many hands until it reaches yours.
Yeah.
And to sort of like re-cleanse that energy.
Oh, so, wow.
And
I
make
like that.
And make that energy yours.
Oh.
We kind of re-cleanse with Palo Santo. So, yeah. So basically we, back to this piece, it's white snake, it's a triple bracelet, and we made it from a different kind of stone in the beginning, which was sort of like a buffalo bone.
Okay.
Buffalo bone beads.
Yeah.
But we just noticed that it didn't age the way that we wanted, okay, or that we sort of like, yeah, would be sort of acceptable for us, if you like.
Yeah,
so we changed the stone into this a different stone, basically.
Nice. It looks stunning.
That just looks really, really nice.
From what I'm seeing is like even the light, and it makes
very clean look. You know, very nice for the summer with this little pop of color.
If honestly, if I had the budget, I would probably have a bracelet for each day of the week. You know, to try and. But I think I'm gonna start off because the next one I'm looking to order is again similar to this. You know, very close to the connotation I'm trying to achieve. But I'm looking at how the white is coming out. I'm trying to find a reason for some kind of vanilla chocolate.
Oh, yes, definitely. Customers find reasons all the time just to treat themselves for something new.
That's good.
Okay,
so now question. I've really, really got to learn about how you actually make the bracelet. Now, we're living some tough times, okay? I can't even talk about Brexit anymore because even though everyone claims it's over and done with, it's in the background. We got COVID. What are Rocktonica plans for the future to stay liquid and competitive? Because at the end of the day, when I say liquid and competitive, to make sure that when someone has lost a job, they don't have the budget to buy an expensive jewelry or they treat themselves to it, you know. So what are your plans to make sure you guys are able to stay afloat, if not move on to bigger things? What's your future plans?
I always like to take a positive outlook on everything that's happening, because with every situation, there is the good and the bad. And if you want the bad, you'll find it.
Mm.
And if you want the good, you'll also find it. So, I mean, the thing about this situation that we're going through right now is that people, you know, haven't been going out as much.
Yeah.
So with that, you know, there has been a lot more of of disposable income for them to actually treat themselves to something.
Right.
You know, because they're not going out as much. They're not going out on weekends as much. They're not eating out as much.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're still having the same income, but actually they want to treat themselves now.
Okay.
So that could be a very positive thing, like in whatever sector you're in.
Correct.
And the other thing is like people have been also like shopping online much.
Oh, that's
much
true.
More.
That's true.
So again, that can, you know, that will have a positive impact on many, many industries and has done. So, you know, like I said, whichever sort of like angle you look at it, if you want to find the good, you will find the good.
Right.
So I think that, you know, marketing is very, very important. You know, branding is very, very important. And just always coming up with, new and exciting products that our customers are going to love.
And so that's what Rocktonica plans, to stay competitive and for the future. Okay.
I mean, that's, I think that's any cost, like any company's plan if they want to be successful. I don't think it's something that's really unique to us.
Okay.
And I wouldn't say that there's like a super special formula for Rocktonica that's only unique to us.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's all nuanced.
Yeah.
You know, but these are all important things that I think any company should be looking at right now.
Okay. So, final question. If I was I won't put a young age to it, but it could be anyone, 16-year-old. Nowadays, you have business entrepreneurs starting at the age of 14. But if I was a young person looking to start off, I don't have your background in design. I don't have your how would you say, romantic connection with the world of jewelry, okay? And I want to start a business in this jewelry.
Yeah. In jewelry or in general?
I jewelry, not general, because I want to see what would you advise.
Oh yeah, for sure.
For your industry.
So I mean, I would say try to educate yourself as much as possible.
Okay.
And you know, that could be done in different ways. That could be done through self-education, mm-hmm. or it could be done by, you know, going to work for a brand that you really love, you know, and just like that, I think is incredibly invaluable, because you see from the inside how many things are done.
Yeah.
And I think definitely the experience that you have or you would get from that, it would be invaluable.
Right.
And try to also educate yourself on the business side of things, which is very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
And test your ideas very early, I would say, would be my final advice. Like, test your ideas very, very, very early.
Mm.
I mean, you know, if you think that you have a great idea, and I hear this all the time, you know, that I have this great idea, you know, and, you know, I just need some funding. I'm like, okay, so what do you need the funding for?
Mm.
Oh, to buy products.
Mm-hmm.
And like, for every time I hear that, you know, this alarm bell rings, that you're just gonna get a warehouse full of products.
Mm-hmm.
And you think, okay, I'm gonna load this warehouse full of products, and then that's my problem solved. That is actually the beginning of your worst nightmare. You know, because you haven't tested your idea, and you don't know for sure that these products, you're relying on the fact that these products will be flying off the shelf
yeah.
the next day, you know. Whereas if you actually, and right now, like, the barrier to market is so low
mm.
that you can actually really simply, you know, test your products with customers, or test your products with, you know, I call them the three F's: friends, family, and fools. You know, so these are the three people that everyone has access to.
Yes.
I would say test early and get feedback. You know, get feedback, be realistic, have self-awareness, you know. And if you're getting feedback that your ideas are doing great, you know, and you're confident, then take it to the next level and the next level and the next level. If not, then you need to go back to the drawing board, you know, without investing a huge amount of money and time into something that you're not sure about.
Nice.
You know, because ideas are always about iteration.
Yeah.
You know, and you can just iterate an idea and iterate an idea and iterate an idea and actually end up with something that you didn't think about in the first place.
Right.
And that could end up being, you know, your winning ticket.
Yeah. No, that's actually really good advice, especially the whole element of, I like the three F's: friend, families, and fools. To use them as your,
yeah,
as your kind of, you know, your how would you say, ability to gauge if your idea is good. So I know, I like that. Honestly, Ahmed, and like I said, thank you very much for this time. Before I leave you in peace, yeah, any last words you want to give? A shout out to my Nomadic Delights followers.
Any last words? I would say, So I mean, are your followers, are they entrepreneurs or are they?
They're a mixed bunch, and of course there's a lot of Somaliland orientated and angle, but no, to be honest, the way I like to talk about when I bring my guests on are the people like you, you know, successful entrepreneurs, people who are in different kind of fields, but more importantly, people who need some kind of guidance on how to do certain projects. And the fact is, I've always wanted you on this show for quite a while, not only because you're a friend, but also what you're doing is such a unique take on what you bring.
Thank you.
You know, honestly, and for me, I've said it, I used to value watches. Yeah, but for me, my definition of a watch was like, hey, that's something that defines me as a man. But then I realized as I got a bit older, watches are not really, you know, there are many expensive watches out there, but whereas jewelry, if you can have a story with it, and it's also quality, not the little trinket off the beach, like you said, because the amount of time you bought some little, you know, I used to live in different parts of, and yes, they do break. So I've enjoyed my quality bracelet from Rocktonica, and I'm, you know, I'm looking to
Thank
grab
you.
Some more. So, and I like the fact you said it's a whole customer rock star service we're getting. So I'm make
you.
Sure I'm a call
Thank
upon
you.
That. Yeah?
Oh yeah, no, you're welcome anytime. Yeah, maybe I would close by saying this, and maybe I haven't, maybe this is not 100% accurate, but there is a there is a quote that goes, don't look at something and say how.
Yeah. Look at something.
Look at an idea that hasn't happened, yeah, and say what if.
Ah, nice. And I think that's what you did with Rocktonica, because I don't see anyone else.
I haven't quoted this 100% accurately, but I think I've just communicated the essence of what I'm trying
exactly.
to say.
Exactly, it might mean that's the main thing. No, but I think that's a good, how would I say, good final words. But honestly, Ahmed, it's been a pleasure like always.
Thank you.
I'll leave you to it, and inshallah, see you next time, my friend.
See
yeah?
you next time. Right,
take care.
Take care. All the best.
All the best.
Well, that's all, folks. Thank you for listening to my podcast, which is simply the reflections of a nomad consultant living life on a day-by-day basis. I just want to conclude by saying I appreciate the love and support you guys are showing me. Until the next time, peace and love.